It's been a while since I have installed my solar panels on my vents, almost a year now, and I wanted to have a look at the performance of my batteries, what are the actual cold cranking amperes, and the capacity and voltage, and let's have a look, shall we?
Very common flooded lead acid battery,
which you can meet in mostly every car.
This battery wasn't new, but I took the measurements before installing the solar panels. The rated power is 750 cold cranking amps, and the capacity of the battery 74 ampere hours. Internal resistance has dropped significantly, and instead of 740 cold cranking ampere, it still has 677, which is really good. Now let's have a look at the Lygia battery, which is behind the driver's seat. I need to disconnect the battery wires to get the access to measure the capacity of the battery, and I have disconnected them yesterday. Charging both of the battery through the original relay of the Lygia battery, and now it's on, now it's off. So whenever I park it for long, I just turn it on and it's charging. Also, let's have a look how much power it has already produced. MPPT solar charge controller from ePower. So in total, it already has produced 15.5 kilowatt hours of power, which is quite a lot, just from charging the batteries. This is also a lead acid battery, and the rated power 740 amperes. And capacity 80 ampere hours. This one was completely new battery, very good internal resistance, which means the battery is still in mint condition, and CCA is very, very high. And the inverter is here. It was very long, so I couldn't find a better place where I can place it. 2 kilowatts of power through sinus wave power inverter. The status of the battery, perfect. And the wires is not so long. Go through there. Carmela also has a solar battery on the roof, which I sticked it here. It has a also a flooded lead acid battery, which was manufactured in Ukraine. Really good batteries. At one time I was selling them in Europe, in my home country. Its rated capacity 74 ampere hours and power 760 amperes. It's the heaviest battery on the market. Okay, the internal resistance is really good for a lead battery, is really good, and the CCA is also very high. Instead of 760, it has 965. Well, I disconnected the batteries yesterday to get a more accurate result. It has a very simple setup. Cheaper controller, even though the manufacturer of the controller states that this is MPPT controller. It's hard to believe because of the price and the actual components, but in general it's quite alright, and it's doing what it's supposed to do. Keeps the battery charged. At first it was hanging on a wall, but now it's a little bit messy and I can't find a perfect place for that controller. Also, for comparison, this is a daily driven car, which battery was placed new something like a year ago. And let's compare how is it doing. Rated power 68 amperes, capacity 72 ampere hours. Let's plug it and have a look. It's already showing that the battery is low and internal resistance higher than the new ones in the vans. CCA also dropped, but it's, of course, it depends on the voltage, so this one dropped.